Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Minecraft! Yeah! 25th episode is here! Okay, bad for me. Let's just do this real quick. Yeah. So, welcome back to another episode of Minecraft. And this is episode 25. And 25 episodes have gone by. Quite a bit have changed. Quite a bit has changed in this world since the very start. So, I am doing a world tour, and then at the end there's something special. I have finished up some projects and half finished another project, so getting there. So this is my house. Yeah, I'm getting right into the world tour. This is my house. This is at the bottom. A jukebox that's playing right now. That's my favorite song. This is my goodies chest, but that's not my only goodies chest. Oh, I had a waste crack. Ooh, that's weird. And this is what the house looks like outside. You just saw my main room up there. Oh, man, my voice hurts now. And then over here, as a decoration, a few episodes back, I think it was like episode 16/17, I worked on this a little bit to make this all look really good. It looks pretty good, I'd say, but there is room for improvement. There's always room for improvement, in my opinion. And back here, it's a little bit sloppier than over there, but it's all hidden lighting and it lights everything up. And, over here, there's a balcony sort of thing over there. Got a path over here, got a gate here, and then another one up there. With the same pressure plate thing, so I can just jump off into there, and actually I'll put my latches on. Still don't have the right bow for it, because I haven't been bothered to do any enchanting, I've just been building non-stop now. That's my house. Over here, we have an elevator. This is a minecart elevator, these are pretty well known, I'd say. And one day I'll make it go down a lot further, probably. I don't know why, because I already have a bunch of stuff going down there. So maybe there's going to be a basement sort of thing, but I could just make it go like there. I don't know. And I haven't finished that up yet, I should have probably finished it, but there's going to be a path going over to here to meet up about here with the ground. Actually, over here, not here, about here. So yeah, there's a cave. I was very scared to go into this cave at first, yeah, but then later, this cave is sort of the cave where, like, if I get lost underground, yeah, I usually find this cave and I go up here, and, like, oh, I'm home, nice. It's actually quite funny because it's weird like that. Over here's my outside nether hub, basically an entrance to the nether. I'll check that out later. Man, my voice really did mess up there. Shouldn't have shouted it. This is my first sugarcane farm. Every full harvest is a stack and a half sugarcane. That's pretty nice. And my animals and my farm, which the whole thing hasn't finished yet, and you just saw a chicken burn over there. All of these buttons are connected to the dispensers back there, which dispense water. Oh man, my voice really does hurt now. Like seriously, over here's gonna be a melon/pumpkin farm. Same here. I haven't decided which one's gonna be which yet. Here's a little simple chicken cooker, cooked chicken, some feathers. Some of the cooked chicken gets lost, but the feathers always go in though. And just a little breeding thing over here. Access to wiring, which is something I usually do. Lights, same over there. And this is my storage right now. That's pretty much all I have. I've been eating the carrots lately, like lots, and yeah, they're actually pretty good because they're so easy to get, but they're nowhere near as good as these. Like, I can probably eat a stack of these in the time that I eat about 4 stacks of carrots, maybe even 5. But yeah, going over here, we have a bridge. You can fit a boat underneath this. And in the last episode, we worked on the beacon here a little bit. One day, I shouldn't have said one day. I just uploaded Mass Record. Well, I made it accessible to the public because I hit 50 subs and it's now 52. So thank you everyone so much. This is like two-part thing, and yeah. Over here is going to be a mob system, which I've never finished. Oh yeah, by the way, over there there's going to be a control room sort of thing. You'll know what I'm talking about when I actually finish it, and there's going to be a window on the other side, so when you're passing on the boat, you can look. It's kind of like going to be really cool sort of thing, hopefully. Over here is mob system, which is not finished yet. I haven't worked on it in ages. And this is my village. The original idea was for me to, stop treating Dylan the hacker. I promise I will hack you one day. Stop treating. You're just spamming my phone right now. Just stop. I declare war on Dylan the hacker. I wonder who wins. It will probably be me because I'm gonna team up with Anonymous. Just kidding. I have nothing to do with Anonymous. Or do I? So the original plan of the village was to have a bunch of villages like scattered around the world, but like near some kind of bases. Like I'm gonna have a base everywhere pretty much. Man, my voice. So this is supposed to be like a woodland village. This is supposed to be like in the woods. I should probably plant some trees around here, but you know, I haven't worked on this village in ages. Well, I mean, I still put things in here, but I don't work on the decorating part anymore, just on what's useful. So that is the first house I built with a little window. You cannot go upstairs. And this is the second house I built. Actually check what's on the other side here. There's a little farm here, just so it looks pretty cool, and path locks. And over here is what this is, a boat dispenser. This is the receiving part of the boat, so you put your boats in here and you receive them from there. But now that I think about it, I could have made it way simpler than this. Like, way simpler, you could not believe. Like, I wanted to have boats changed, yeah, and I wanted to have a boat dispenser here, like a normal dispenser, dispense boats up here when I shot an arrow at a pressure plate, yeah. That would have worked in 1.8, no problem. Yeah, because boats were still like that, but now boats can flood and sink, and now that idea doesn't work, so I had to make something that doesn't require you to break the boats, so they stay in the sea. And yeah, there's a bunch of piston blocks up there, so I can, it's actually pretty slow. And there's a button over there that activates it. It just sends a quick pulse to an iron trapdoor over there, and that releases one boat, and that's the boat. Oh, come on, stop tweeting. You know what, I'm gonna put my phone onto airplane mode. That's so much better. Not gonna get any more tweets. Oh yeah, but I'm not gonna get any fan comments either about anything, so I'm putting it back on. Okay, so yeah, this could be a lot simpler, but I didn't go with a simple thing. I had to make it difficult. This is how you return boats. Pretty simple. That basically allows you to stay there for as long as you need to be. Over here is a church. This is, I wanted to have some kind of like man standing there, not Jesus, and have like light rays coming from behind him, but it turned into Jesus because there's not enough space here. And this is church. Some of these item frames got blown up when the creeper blew up over there. Still haven't replaced these because I really don't care for churches. And over here, actually something I haven't checked out in absolutely ages, is bell. Yeah, my volume's turned down like a lot, so yeah. That's why you can barely hear it, so yeah. Yeah, see, someone liked my photo on Instagram. Told you I should keep it on. Over here is a statue thing, which is the first thing I actually built in the village. That's the first house. And basically every village that I was going to build was supposed to have one of its own statues, so to like kind of identify it as a theme. So this theme is nature, obviously, and what I really wanted to do is do a hell theme, because I'm all about hell and stuff, so yeah. Over here is a little mine thing, entrance to a mine. I think I looked made it look pretty realistic. Over here is just a random chest, and over here I still haven't filled this in. I'm actually quite guilty of not filling this in. And then there's a, you can go down here, made this look like a mine shaft going down, an abandoned mine shaft sort of thing, although I could have put cobwebs there. And this is just a quick way up and down, and this is where the other thing goes. And then, yeah, these, whatever they're called, strip mines, yeah. And also I realised that this is off-center, so I'm going to have to move this two blocks that way. Fun! Or I could just move it one block that way, which is probably actually what I'm going to do. It's a lot simpler, and it will stay the same size I want it to be. And going up is kind of like a little stressful, but I know that will make it, but feels like it's not going to, especially at the end over there. Well, no, sorry, back there. It used to be at near the end, but I put more powered rails there. Never mind, over here is a little project randomizer. So you put random projects in here, yeah. And you press the button, and you get a project in here, and it will choose one at random for you. But I was a little picky. Okay, that's a monument. Monument for this, I mean. And there's more projects, there's like 5 more there, but they're in here somewhere. Yeah, this is wiring again. This is the wiring to the whole thing. So the next project is storage room, and the reason I have to have these here is because, actually, now that I think about it, I can't activate this unless there's another project in there, or here. Because, never mind, I'll just put a filler in there. But yeah, this is so, because only the first slot gets taken out, so all of these would never be used. And, yeah. Ooh, cinematic mode. Note to that. And yeah, this is my storage room. This is my biggest storage room so far. My stone and stone related things, so ores, dirt, some mycelium here, wood, and natural stuff, yeah, got that right. Sand/gravel. Mob loot, which I barely put any in here, and clay, because one day I want to find a mason biome and have this filled with colored clay. Weapons/armor, I should probably change that to tools, and glass, and redstone, I had a lot more, but I just did a big project. These are my goodies. I've got a ton of iron now, again, and that's because I went caving again because I needed to, what's it called? It's for another thing. The bars on my nether tunnel need to be, it's like a window, but Garth can't see through it, so yeah, that's the whole point. And over here is a little blacksmith. I don't know why I just went around the back. Little porch over here, that's the blacksmith. And this is pretty cool. This is glowing, yeah, so it looks like coals. And then over here I've got fire charges, and then up there I have a fire, so it looks like there's smoke, and also it's very faint. It's very faint indeed, but it seems like these are crackling. Yeah, you heard that just there. And then there's, you can light that and this will extinguish itself. Got some ferni, chest, and a barrel, an anvil, and a bed, of course. Because I only had one before that. So this should extinguish itself, and I'll just turn my environment back down to 10. Yeah, it's extinguished itself, so now we can carry on. Man, I think this is going to be a long episode. Over here I just finished up. You might not know what this is if you're new to the channel. This is a firework workshop. I've been working all day today. I've played for at least 12 hours today, and I actually finished two projects. Well, yeah, two projects. I started one today and finished it. I just need to polish it up to make it look better, but I don't care if it looks bad on the inside, because I'm not going to go down there often anyway. And yeah, I finished that today, and you'll see what it is at the end of the episode. And yeah, this is a firework workshop, and I finished it up today, and everything is lit up in the corners. It is 8, so that's very nice. And I'm gonna remove these chests sometime soon. Yeah, this is where my other redstone is. And I can show you how this works, actually. So I'll check out the wiring in just a little bit. So you press this button to start, get a bunch of materials for making fireworks. Sometimes you get a lot less than this. This was just a random chance, and you can throw it in the hopper and it will dispense again. Why am I getting so many? I swear I put more items into the randomizer so it has less chance of picking them. Ideally, what you do is you will clear the hotbar and just press the button that it's on, so you can do that sort of thing real quick. And yeah, if you want to finish making, yeah, see, sometimes it even messes up. Okay, now I'm gonna have to do this until I get just something. Every time you get at least one gunpowder, by the way. Okay, good. I can make one of each. Ah, I shouldn't have done that. Okay, it doesn't matter. And when you want to finish, it's really simple. You just keep the item that you want. Well, you just keep these in your inventory and then go over here and throw them out. And that carries on onto this part, which I've also started and finished today. This is for making the actual fireworks. And I have duration of 2 because I like my fireworks reasonably high. And you just do the same thing, pretty much. Huh, I didn't get the paper. It gets stuck somewhere. Can't reach. Just do this real quick. Sometimes it doesn't. It can malfunction, but you can fix it. You can't fix anything. Where did the other gunpowder go? Redstone's weird, you know, in these updates. But yeah, and once you want to finish creating them, you just do the same thing, but over here now. Everything should go into here. Yeah, and you might notice that this wasn't the one we just made. It's because I'm using an item elevator, and I didn't build it quite correctly, but I don't care, and it will keep two items behind depending on its length, but both of the item elevators are going to be kept back. And so these are the item randomizers. Over here is the wiring. So this is the hopper, so you press the button, this turns off, this turns on, sends a signal, and when an item goes through the hopper, sends a signal also. And just going back up. Over here, it shows up to here, and these are the randomizers. I don't care if you don't know. Here's a second button. Ah! That's where they're getting stuck. I forgot to cover this. So that's. Wow, I'm dumb. I am dumb as hell. Anyway, this is the item elevator, and there's a chest there, just in case. I'd like to take that, thank you. There's actually quite a few fireworks here. Charges, I mean. Oh, yeah. Keep forgetting that I have haste. It almost scares me when I accidentally use it. Yeah, that's the wiring. I don't care about that wiring, because it's never gonna mess up anyway. And you can access it from both sides. Unfortunately, that's not centered there, so I don't like it as much. But poof, it's been a long time since I did a cut, so it's cut time. Cut. I can't whistle. Finally, next thing we're going to check out is a sugarcane farm, just over there. I would like to have rivers, like, everywhere, almost, because, like, it's fun to ride boats. Like, if you can make everything look really nice around the river, then it's really fun riding the boats, and here's the big sugarcane farm, but, you need to be, like, right here for it to be loaded in, because I'm special, and I built too far from my main base, and I never go here. Therefore, this is useless, but, no, hut here. I go AFK here quite often, and I forgot to put these away. Doesn't matter. Got some stuff, and got down here, got extra storage. One day these will all be full. But yeah. This is a pattern to maximize the amount of space you use per sugarcane thing, whatever I just said. And there's lighting underneath, so at night this looks pretty cool. And going back, can I pick this guy up? Because boats, right? No, I can't pick him up unless I exit the boat. This is a small experiment, guys. Just bear with me a second. No, it doesn't work on them, apparently. Just dogs and other humans. I did a project right over here. It is underground, most of it, so you will not see it right now. But yeah, you'll know what it is at the end of the episode. And over here I have a bunch of I don't like these new boat controls. Bunch of big trees, which is where I get a bunch of my wood from usually, and passing right underneath this. And over here there's gonna be a window to look into. It's gonna look all mechanical and stuff. And then I don't know why I'm going here by boat, and yeah, it's weird. Over here there used to be an island, but then I cleared it out, and besides this was supposed to be a lake, I think. Yeah, this was, wow, that's weird. Forests and plains. Ah, how I wish I had an enderpearl. Okay, I'm just gonna have to climb then. Taking a small break from explaining and stuff, let's look at my statistics and achievements after this. So, Game Squirt. I played on this nearly 200 times, that's awesome. Minutes played, nearly 4 days. This should be a lot more, it got reset for some reason. Okay, sneak time. That's a lot. Distance walked. Oh, that's a lot as well. Distance crouched. Distance sprinted. Distance swam. Fallen. You can just look through these. I'm going to look through them as well, so I'm not going to go too fast. Since when? Since when? Since when? Ah, I know. It's when I use my elevator. It apparently counts as distance by minecart. That's weird. Boat is catching up with that. Okay. That's going to go up a lot. That's a lot of jumps, but on parkour maps it's a lot more than that. And damage dealt, about 6 times more than damage taken. Just 5.9 times more than damage taken, actually. Number of deaths, 8. And mob kills, animal spread. Don't do much fishing, do I? Talk to villagers quite a bit, traded with villagers enough. Not enough. Enough for a first time. When? Okay, blocks. These are probably gonna be all messed up because my world is really messed up. I'll just say right now that All my spawners that I have found so far, apart from the ones in the Nether, are all for some reason pig spawners, and they don't work. So that my game has been really messed up. So this is dropped, picked up, mined, used, and crafted. Okay. Let's have a quick look through this. Oh, okay. That's all for the netherrack. You can pause the video if you want to look at these closer items now. I'm just skipping through these now because I don't have much time left. And mobs. I've never been killed by a mob, apparently, by any mobs. Every time I've been killed, it's because I, like, fell or something. Yeah. Killed a lot of villagers because I made a little villager breeder. And my achievements. There are three more to go, basically. This will be done soon. You need to find one, and never happening. Okay, and also I have this thing up there. When I press tab, it shows my deaths, just because I wanted to do that real quick. And over here is my little ice farm. And there's an AFK thing here, whilst you're waiting for the ice to form. And most of the time I don't do an AFK, I just do these tricks. Like backflips sort of thing. Don't even know what they're called now. Eh! Ah, didn't make it. Parkour, this is. And where shall we go now? There is one more place in the overworld, but it's not worth checking it out, so let's just go to the Nether. And there's my boat down there. To the Nether we go. Oh, that was so nice. Oh, wow. I'm impressed with myself today. I'm impressed. So this is my Nether hub, work in progress. Bunch of chests full of stuff. There's a ghast somewhere here, which is really annoying me. I hate ghasts so much. And over here is a tunnel I've been working on for the last few episodes, although I didn't really show much work on it. And I've been working it very hard, and I have finished the tunnel itself, but I now need to add these stairs and ice below it. And then I need to do the rails, and it's still gonna be a big pain. And these are the iron bars that I was talking about. And also the stairs prevent the pigmen from spawning. And as you can see, I was nowhere near finishing the ice, and we will now go to where this goes to, which is a blaze farm. So ghast can now see me, and I'm really scared, and there's a ghast over there. There's two ghasts actually. One right in front of me and one somewhere to the left. Nice. And actually whilst I was building this, after the corner of my eye, yeah, I noticed that there's another fortress over there, like right there, and I could have just carried on going straight instead of having to turn a bunch of times, which would have made it way more convenient. Yeah, can you see it off the corner of my eye? Never mind. What's done is done. I'm just gonna put this on because Nether is scary. Even though I have good stuff on me. That's actually probably what makes it so scary. I don't want to lose my stuff. My wrist still hurts. So this is basically the whole journey, and it will be way more faster when there's a minecart here. And was it today? I think it was yesterday that I finished this. So over here is the Blaze Farm. There's the spawner, a little what's it called, funnel. Here's a way to go out into the Nether, and here's where you kill them. You can do a splash potion, and that will just bring them down to half a heart. You can either throw a splash potion of harming. Well, I found out that I was wrong again, because apparently it will deal half a heart of damage to all to everything that's there if you do the slash attack. But it will do most damage to the one that you're actually hitting. And here's another storage room over here. And the chest. This is my inner chest. This is my backup gear right here. One with a skeleton skull, some ice, which is for the tunnel there. An enchanting room, and that's pretty much it for this. Yeah, I'm gonna get out of here now. Wait a second, there's a few more things. I figured out how to go, I just reloaded the world. There's an enchanting room here with an anvil, and there's a little storage room for the enchanting room, so there's a bunch of picks here. Shovels, swords, and random stuff, axes, and these are for books, and this is for bow. And up here, I mean, down here, a little automatic furnace. This is the only one there is so far, and got a bunch of fuel, all blaze rods, and yeah, now we're done. And I was wrong again. I didn't show my armor. So underwater breather, demon wings, a big thing, some pants, some boots, slayer, careful miner, screwdriver, gravedigger, tree chopper, and exo sniper. Okay, now we're done. And we're done for sure now. Alright then, what I wanted to show you earlier, well, I didn't want to show you actually, was this. It is a firework thing. Now it explains why I wanted to make the firework workshop thing. And let's get this running. Just got randomizers here, like I was in the fireworks thing, and got random fireworks. And there's chests for it if you like want tons, but I didn't make loads because I ran out of resources actually. So let this run. That's pretty sweet. That is pretty sweet. Oh, I'm missing it. Thank you for 50 subs, everyone. And thank you for, well, thank me for 25 episodes of this. Yay! Oh, this is so awesome. I love fireworks in Minecraft. You can see them rise as well. It's so cool. And they also have the sound thing, where sound travels. And is slower than light. Ah, this is so awesome. Ah, there's some grey ones. Oh, that's ugly. I think that's it. Oh no, a few more. There's 15 of those lime ones. That was pretty annoying, actually. But, thank you for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Ooh, bye bye. Just take a screenshot of that. Okay. Bye bye.